May the Sacred Heart of Jesus be ever loved, forever. Our Lady of the Sacred Heart, pray for us. Saint Joseph, model and patron of those who love the Sacred Heart of Jesus, pray for us. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Prayer for the first week of Advent. All-powerful God, increase our strength of will for doing good, that Christ may find an eager welcome at His coming, and call us to His side in the kingdom of heaven, where He lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Self-satisfaction is neither attained nor found in earthly things. Life, then, always seeks for more each time a certain thing is reached or achieved. This now would lead us to question a lot of things in which an answer is difficult to be found. However, if we look into the life of the great believers, they attained the fullness of life because they lived a life with Jesus Christ. Please stand to honor the Holy Gospel. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. At that time, Jesus walked by the Sea of Galilee, went up on the mountain, and sat down there. Great crowds came to him, having with them the lame, the blind, the deformed, the mute, and many others. They placed them at his feet, and he cured them. The crowds were amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the deformed made whole, the lame walking, and the blind able to see. And they glorified the God of Israel. Jesus summoned his disciples and said, "My heart is moved with pity for the crowd, for they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. I do not want to send them away hungry, for fear they may collapse on the way." The disciples said to him, "Where could we ever get enough bread in this deserted place to satisfy such a crowd?" Jesus said to them, "How many loaves do you have?" "Seven," they replied, "and a few fish." He ordered the crowd to sit down on the ground. Then he took the 7 loaves and a fish, gave thanks, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied. They picked up the fragments left over, 7 baskets full. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pause for a moment as we reflect on the message of the Holy Gospel. As we live our life in different ways, different standards are also observed. The kind of lifestyle that we are used to is mostly the usual thing that we are at home of living. However, life on one hand is dynamic. It seeks for a change, especially if during at times that it is no longer satisfied with the usual. That is why there is this time for us that we explore more in life just to find satisfaction on earthly things. Yet, as these satisfactions are met, they don't last for long. In the Gospel reading, people were fed by Jesus with bread and fish, which satisfied their hunger, which is part of their human nature. Looking into it, satisfaction is highlighted. But if we will dig deeper into this context, the very satisfaction that was truly experienced by the people was the fullness of life experienced through following and listening from Him. With that, let us learn to seek satisfaction in life with Jesus Christ so that we may be able to experience Him as the fullness of everything. Memorary to Our Lady of the Sacred Heart. Remember, Our Lady of the Sacred Heart, the great things the Lord has done for you. He chose you for His mother. He wanted you close to His cross. He gives you a share in His glory. He listens to your prayer. Offer Him our prayers of praise and thanksgiving. Present our petitions to Him. Let us live like you in the love of your Son, that His kingdom may come. Lead all people to the source of living water that flows from His heart, spreading over the world hope and salvation, justice and peace. See our trust in you. Answer our prayer. Show yourself always our Mother. Amen.
Oratio Imperata for Protection Against COVID-19. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael the Archangel, pray for us. San Roque, pray for us. San Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. San Pedro Calungsod, pray for us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Mary, with her loving Son, bless us each and everyone. Amen. That in all things, God may be glorified.